A car, a fast car. The house, the haunted house. A girl, a small, intelligent, pious girl. What is the difference between sentence number one and sentence number two in each of these examples? If you can see that in each of these examples, I have described the noun using descriptive words, then you are correct. In this lesson, that is exactly what we will be covering. Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in, amma ba'd. This is lesson number 8 from the 10 lessons that we will be covering. I will keep this lesson as easy and as simple as I possibly can. In this lesson, we will look at a new concept using examples and illustrations. I will include new vocabulary, homework, and also supporting notes, including word mats, in the description below. This is so that you can download and get hold of any of these resources that you desire. Finally, I will leave you with a question at the end, which you can think about and then respond back to me and let me know what you think the answer is. This is lesson number 8, known as Mawsoof Sifah, or in English as we know it as adjectives. Let's begin with an example just to ease ourselves into this concept that we will be covering. If I was to say a boy and a tall boy, what is the difference between the two sentences? In the second sentence, I have described the boy using a descriptive word, which in English is known as an adjective. So the word tall is the adjective and the boy is the person who this description is referring to. In Arabic, the adjective is known as a sifah and the person or the thing who you are describing is known as a mawsoof. So, if you had a tall boy, the word tall would be your sifah and the boy would be the mawsoof. Now in Arabic, the only difference in comparison to English is that in Arabic they bring the person or the thing who you are describing first and then the adjective comes afterwards. So where you would have the tall boy, boy would come first and tall would come second, meaning the mawsoof, whoever you're describing, would come first and the sifah, the describing word, would come second. Let's take a look at a few examples just to digest this concept. So, a round ball, a large house, a beautiful museum, a fast car. In all of these examples, whichever word is being used to describe something, that word in English is known as an adjective, and in Arabic is known as a sifah. So when translating, you bring the adjective second, and you bring the thing or the person you are talking about first. Let's take a look at what the sifah is in each of these sentences. So the example of a round ball, round is the description. A large house, large is the description. A beautiful museum, beautiful is the description. A fast car, fast is the description. So all of those words in Arabic are known as sifah, which in English we would call them adjectives. If you spotted all of the adjectives in each and every one of those sentences and you know who or what was being described, then you understand the concept of mawsoof sifah and it is as simple as that. Now, one of the rules of mawsoof sifah is that when someone or something is being described, both of the words have to match in four things. If they match in four things, then that sentence or that phrase can be classed as mawsoof sifah. What are the four things? Number one is that the state of both of them must be exactly the same. So if the first word has two dhamma, two kasra, two fatha, the second word needs to have the same. If the first word has one fatha, one dhamma, one kasra, the second word needs to have the same. Secondly, if the first word has an alif lam, the second word also needs to have an alif lam, meaning if the first word is a proper noun, the second one also needs to be a proper noun. The third one is that the genders must match. If the first word is masculine, the second word needs to be masculine as well. If the first word is feminine, the second one needs to be feminine. And lastly, the number needs to match. So if the first word is talking about singular, dual, or plural, based on that, the second word would also follow in singular, dual, or plural. Let us take an example from the Quran, focusing on these four aspects. In Surah Al-Fatiha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, اِهْدِنَا الصَّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ Guide us towards the straight path. Our focus is on الصَّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ, meaning guide us towards the straight path. The path is being described and the word that is being used is straight. So it is telling you what kind of path it is. So let's focus on الصِّرَاطَ and الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. Now, the four things that we've said. Number one, state. Do they match in state? الصِّرَاطَ has a fatha. الْمُسْتَقِيمَ has also a single fatha. الصِّرَاطَ has an alif lam before it. So الْمُسْتَقِيمَ also has an alif lam before it. الصِّرَاطَ is masculine. الْمُسْتَقِيمَ is masculine. الصِّرَاطَ is singular. So الْمُسْتَقِيمَ is also singular. In Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 10, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ And for them is a painful punishment. Here, the punishment is being described and the word that is being used is painful. So, what is being described? عَذَاب. So, عَذَاب is your mawsoof and the descriptive word, meaning the adjective, is أَلِيمٌ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ If we take a look at it, عَذَابٌ has two ضَمَّ, أَلِيمٌ has two ضَمَّ. عَذَابٌ has no alif lam, أَلِيمٌ has no alif lam, and so forth. So because we can see that it matches in all aspect, this is an example of موصوف صِفَة, a word basically that is being described. وَلَهُمْ and for them is a severe punishment. I will share one final example with you from Surah Ibrahim, Surah number 14, ayah 24, in which there are two examples in a single ayah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا كَلِمَةً طَيِّبَةً كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ This is where our focus is. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that have you not seen how Allah sets forth an example, how Allah presents an example? كَلِمَةً طَيِّبَةً A good word. So here the word is being described and the descriptive word is good. It is a good word. كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ Like a tree, the shajara, the tree is being described as طَيِّبَة. A good word is like a good tree. Now let's analyze the first one. What is being described? The word كَلِمَة, meaning a word, is being described. Described as what? طَيِّبَة, meaning it is good. كَلِمَةً has two fatha, so the sifa, the descriptive word, has also two fatha, طَيِّبَةً. But in the second example, the word that comes after it, كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ, here, شَجَرَةٍ has two kasra. Now we know, if you've watched my lesson on preposition, the ka, the harf jar, is causing the shajara to have two kasra. Now because the word shajara, that's the word being described, the tree, has two kasra. When you are describing the tree, meaning with the word good, that also has two kasra, meaning it's following its mawsoof, the sifa and mawsoof match with one another. In a nutshell, when someone or something is being described, whoever or whatever that thing is, that will come first in Arabic, and then the descriptive word or the adjective will come second. The first word is going to be known as mawsoof and the descriptive word is known as sifa. Now before we finish this lesson, I'd like you to know that in the description below, I will include new vocabulary and also exercises for you to practice, and also a word mat with different adjectives on it so that you can create your own sentences, making sure that your sentences are very creative and have a variety of adjectives being used in your own sentences. As always, if there is anything you have not understood or have any questions, feel free to contact me and I will get back to you answering each and every one of your questions. As mentioned earlier in the video, I'm going to leave you with a question. The question is, what is the function of each of these words in this sentence and how would you translate it, making sure you got the mawsoof sifah correct? The sentence is, ابن الرجل الصالح. ابن الرجل الصالح. Get in contact with me or leave me a message and let me know your responses and what you think. I pray you enjoyed this lesson and this lesson was of benefit to you. Jazakumullah khair for watching and listening. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.